Welcome to Acreate. I'm Adinda and I provide weekly tutorials for game making enthusiasts. This week I'm going to cover a new game engine, the Clickteam Fusion 2.5, which is a lesser known game engine, but still very good for beginners to start with because you don't really need to code at all. So just let's make a first game in this engine, which will be Pong. Let's start by clicking on New Application in the Start menu to set up a new project. Click on the Thumbnail tab to open the Properties for the Game window and change the background color into black. Click on the Thumbnail to open your application to insert the object in the application. Click with your right mouse button on the background to insert a new object. Now a pop-up will pop up and we will choose an active object to be inserted. Click anywhere on the black background to move it there. Click on the object to open the image controller. Now you can reset its size. Click on the double arrow and set the height to 128 pixels and the width to 16. Click on apply. Now we can fill the shape with the paint bucket tool with a white color and we are ready to go. Clone this object with the right mouse button, clone object, and use the align in frame settings to set its position. Create a new object, this time the ball. Open the image, delete the standard image, resize it by 16 by 16 pixels and use the circle tool to make a round shape for the ball. To make your life easy, it's very important to rename the shapes, otherwise you will have active 1, active 2, active 3, which is crazy. Click on the ball, then go back to the properties menu and click on the move tab. In this tab you can select on type bouncing ball. This is an automatic function for a bouncing ball. You can click on the initial direction to delete some of the standard move. So as you see, the circle is full of all arrows and when you click you can delete some of the directions of the ball. We do something similar with our players. Click on the player, click on the move tab and choose this time for type A direction. And delete all of the other arrows. So we only want the arrow up and down. We do the exact same with the player 2. We go to the move tab and change the type, but we also change the player, so the drop down menu select player 2. Click on the application manager and scroll down in the properties menu till you reach the player settings and click on default controls edit. Click on the first check mark and set up the up to W and the down to the edit. You don't need to reset the settings for player 2 because the standard controls will be the arrow keys up and down. And now your movement is fixed. Open the event editor to make some condition. Click on new condition to set up a new condition. Click on the player 1 and the position test position. And in the pop-up, we will click the two arrows in the frame area. This will check if the player is still in the frame. And click on the box below player 1 to set the movement to stop. This condition makes that the player cannot move out of the frame. Repeat the exact same step for player 2. Just select player 2 and stop the motion on the box from player 2. Now we'll make the condition to make the ball bounce off the player. Click on new condition, click on ball, and click on collision another object. Click on the another object as player 1. Under the little box under the ball, in the same condition, we will check the bounce. Repeat all steps for player 2, but instead collision with the another object will be player 2. On the ball, we will also check if the ball will be out of the scene by test its position and select the up and down arrow. And on the ball, select position, set start position, and click on the frame where you want the ball to reset its position. Now we want to check if the ball left the scene on the left or the right side. Just make the new condition for checking the position and select the left arrow and reset the ball as well. And we do the same with the right settings. So check the position if the ball left on the right. In both cases, we reset the ball in the same position as well. Click again on the settings for the ball, so the box under the ball, and select also the direction. Add for the left side some of the arrows to the left, and for the right side some of the arrows to the right. This to make the game more fair. Run the application to check if everything is working correctly. It is very wise to run the application often to check if you forgot something. I realized I forgot to change the direction when the ball leaves from below or from the top. Go back in the settings and change the direction of the ball for the directions as well. Let's add some score to the game. Click on the frame to open the scene and click on insert object and check in game to set up the score. You can change the fonts in the text options. Don't forget to set the color into white, otherwise you can't see what you're doing. Clone the score for the other player. Reopen the event editor. As you can see, the scores are updated here as well. Now we can use the conditions that check where the ball is leaving the field. So on condition 6, we will add the score under the control 1, add the score, add to 1. And for the right side, we do the same, but then for the player 2 score. I just realized I made a little mistake, because when the ball leaves from the left side, it means that player 2 made a score and not player 1. You can just clone the check by dragging it to the other box and delete the wrong ones. Let's now check who wins the game. Open a new condition, select player 1 and set its player score check to 10. Under the ball, we are going to set that it's going to destroy itself. Make the same condition for the score for player 2, with the 10 and destroying the ball. Go back to the frame to create a new object. This time we want to have some text. Click on the scene insert object and type in text. Now you will see that text is a string. Add the string to the scene. In the paragraph line, we are going to set the text if the player 1 wins. We will add a new paragraph and set in the text player 2 wins in paragraph 2. Don't forget in the font settings to change its color to white. You can change its font settings and the size, but don't forget to also resize the whole object to fit the text if you do so. You can resize the width and the height in the setting. Reopen the event editor. In the condition that we check if player 1 wins, we are going to set on the text objects that it needs to set its paragraph to the first one. On the other condition, for if player 2 wins, then we are going to set the text to paragraph 2. And as we want to have the text only visible at the end of the game, we need to set the text to visibility to reappear. Now we go to the properties of the text, and in the properties menu we go into the tab display, and we are going to uncheck the checkmark visible at start. Go back to the frame to add a button to make it possible to restart the game. Select insert object, in the interface, select button. Set its text to restart. And in the settings tab, under options, uncheck disable on start. We go back to the event editor, and in the conditions that we check if the score is 10, we are going to click on the button, make it visible, make it reappear, and going to set that the button will be reappeared. Do this for both score options, and the new condition we are going to make will be that the button, if it's unclicked, if it's clicked, then under the chessboard in it, we will set the application to restart. Well done, now everything is set to play Pong with yourself or a friend in house. Let me know if you like this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe for more content. This was Acreates. Create more, enjoy more. See you in the next video.